Hey, hey, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of the Cube SMP server. Guys, watch this. I'm a very funny guy, right? I'm gonna be funny again. Here we go. Oh, no! I lit myself on fire! Oh, no! Oh, no! Whatever will I do? I'm on fire! You laughed, right? No? Oh, okay. I thought I might have been funny for once, but you know, we'll just act like that never happened. I'm an idiot. We all know. I hope you have all been having a good day today so far. So we are back on the cube, everybody, and we actually have some things to check out. The first thing I noticed when I got onto the server here, these banners and this. There is a piece of oak wood plank missing from the spawn. Someone made a boo-boo and didn't fill in this block, everybody. We need to file a police report here. Let me go ahead and submit the case. No, I'm just kidding. but it looks like Bionni got on yesterday and he said Bionni's kit shop and Kayani build co are now open. So I think someone added their little fancy message. He's finally just advertising that it's open now. And I think he got on yesterday and restocked the Bionni's kit shop. And I think this is Bionni's official banner. It goes along with his sweatshirt or whatever. Whenever I think of Bionni, I think of the color green. I don't know if you guys are the same way. And actually, before we go ahead and check out the other stuff, I actually do want to check out the kit shop real quick. Oh, he's added these armor stands on the outside. I'm interested to see here. Oh, they have no chance. I should have probably noticed that when it wasn't flashing up. That blaze gets me every time. It scares me. But let me head in here and see what kits he's offering now. So last time we bought the... oh my gosh, someone already bought the PvP kit again. Are you serious? Yesterday I was here and it was the Abba Caving kit and the PvP kit that were gone. Two were sold out. Why would someone want this one? I'm breaking three... I think the only kit that uses my protection 4 book, though, is the PvP kit. So, that means I just got myself 10 gold blocks because I make 25%. So, if there are 40 in here, I get 10 of those. Thank you very much, Bionni dude. And if you're not familiar, as part of this contract, if you're new, we signed a contract where Bionni uses my villager to get all of the protection 4 books. So he gives me 25% of all profits that originate from the kit shop building on the condition that Grazer lets Bionni utilize his protection for villager. So, because he's using it, I get 25% of the profits that were made from the PvP kit here. And so I just made myself 10 gold blocks. Okay, so Stacy's cat, Georgette, has been chilling here right beside the museum window for about 2 days now. Oh, and we haven't had any problems with the chicken jockey, by the way. It hasn't been despawning. It's been safe and sound in there. So the only mob we need left now is the zombie pigman jockey. Once we get that in there, the museum is considered complete. I still need to buy Dolphin out of the museum, though. So we'll do that one day. Hopefully within the coming episodes or so. I would like to get this title all on my own so I can add my banners there. And speaking of banners, I went ahead and added one here because I own part of the mushroom shop. And I added one right here because I own this game, which has not been completed yet. And this is a new build. J-Wong Safety Committee coming soon. Oh, well, we'll have to see what this is. I have no idea. So the mushroom shop. Some of you may have seen on other people's channels. Some of you may have not, so let me summarize it for you. We have gotten two purchases, other than Stacy's purchase that she made last episode, for mooshrooms from two different people. So, Tomahawk went ahead and purchased two mooshroom cows, and Straub went ahead and purchased one, I believe, but he also killed... Did I really just get saved from that? Oh my gosh, that would happen to me. We need to add lights up there. But because Straub only bought one, there was an incident where one of the mushrooms was running around. It might have been Stacy's or something, but it was just running around free, and Straub went ahead and accidentally killed it. So he had to cover the cost of that mushroom, which was an extra 5 gold blocks. So he paid the price of two, but only bought one. Then there was the delivery fee. So I actually have to deliver these mushrooms to both Tomahawk and Straub's houses today. So the total we've made off of this shop so far has been 32 gold blocks and 10 gold ingots. And that is, let's just separate that real quick. Wait, hang on a second. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh yeah, because Stacy's as well. And then 7 gold blocks because I believe... No, something's not adding up here. What's not adding up? Am I missing a purchase? Did someone else make a purchase? Because that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 2 for Tomahawk, 1 for Stacy, 1 for Straub, and the repair fee. Then we had the... Oh, I just remembered I had Straub pay an extra fee because he had me shear the cows. And when you shear a mushroom cow, it turns back into a normal cow. So I got mad at him for that and charged him extra. So that's why that didn't add up for me, because I believe I charged 2 gold blocks and 5 ingots for the fee. So this might add up now. Yes, this adds up now. So 2 delivery fees, 1 to Tomahawk, 1 to Straub, 5 mushroom cows total, 4 bought, 1 paid for in full because of the killing of one, and the shearing fee. So it all adds up, 32 gold blocks, 10 ingots, 75% of 32 is 24. That means I am left with 8 gold blocks on my own, and Pat gets the rest. I'll take 8. And I'm not sure how we're gonna actually, I won't take the 8 right now because I gotta talk to Pat. I don't know how we're gonna split the delivery fees, because those should just be for me, and maybe I should get 25% of the actual cost of the purchases, and delivery fees should be for me. So I'll talk to him about that. I won't take it just yet, but we need to get some wheat, and we need to breed these guys, because we need to deliver 2 to Tomahawk and 1 to Straub today. And if we did that with just the cows we have left, we would have none left, and I'm not trying to go get an import anymore, so we need to go get wheat in order to breed these guys to make more. Woohoo! It turns out there's actually 4 in here. No, there's only 3. Oh, hey, skeleton. You're right behind me. So let's get some baby mooshrooms popping here, and then we can take these guys home. I think we're only able to make 1 baby, because there's only 3. Okay, I went ahead and grabbed the tombola pick. We're gonna have to break this guy out of his slot for just temporary usage. Let's pull you back down into the basement with the other cows, and we're gonna have to breed you, because I want at least 2 baby cows there before we take and import the rest. That way we can repopulate whenever. We probably should have bred these guys a long time ago, now that I think about it. Come here, buddy. And which one was the one that needs love? This guy. Did that make one? Oh, there's 2 now. I think that worked. Okay. Very cool. You come back. Where the heck did that lead just go? I just detached a lead to this guy, and I don't know where... Oh, I see it. It's back there. All right. Going in for it. There we go. Got it. Let's get this guy in here. There we go. All right, ladies and gentlemen. The Miz is specifically for Straub, and then Tomahawk ordered 2 of them. I don't want the babies coming out, though. Only the adults. Is this going to be easy, or is this going to be hard? Can I get all 3 of them out here? This is going to be the hardest part, I think. I love the sound they make when they're behind me. Just that rumbling noise. They're marching. They're marching. Oh my gosh, Straub tricked me. I thought I ran into a dead end, but his portal's right over here. All right, so we're at Straub's house. Here we are. We have all 3 mooshrooms with us. And his is the Miz. So we're going to have to detach the Miz here. I'm going to detach them all, let him roam free for just a second here. Because I have to go ahead and attach the Miz to... We'll just attach him to this fence gate and call it a day. And now we have to bring these 2 guys over to Tomahawk's. So Tomahawk had some specific instructions on where he wanted his placed. Looks like he's left some blocks at his house just laying around. That happens when you log off and no one comes around your chunk. But he wanted me to go ahead and lure them over at this house over here. I don't know if he wanted them inside the house. Does he have? Oh yeah, he's got some fence gates in here. So here, let's lure them inside and we'll put them down, and then we'll be finished our delivery. This door is not allowing them access. There we go. So mushroom number 1, and we're gonna have to detach that one, reattach him. Both mushrooms done, delivery complete. And we'll go ahead and put the door back as well. All right, now that we are finished with the delivery, I would say it's about time. What the heck? Oh, it looks like Kermit's done some work back here. He's actually extending it, making it look nice. Very cool. But there's a problem, guys. I was over here at my Protection 4 Iron Armor stand. 7 gold blocks per usage. I look inside. It's all gone. And I'm thinking to myself, yes! Somebody has used what I like to call the best thing that's ever existed. I go down and check my payments. There's no payment. Except for an iron chestplate and iron boots. I don't know if I put extras down there. I'm pretty sure I remember putting extras down there. But even if that was in there, I'm missing the other 2 armor pieces and no one paid. Interesting. I have no idea who did this. We might have to open up a police case today. And one other thing I wanted to show you guys. The Minute Shop is now open. I think Parker has been holding off on us being allowed to record in here until he uploaded his episode showcasing it all, which was yesterday. So we are going... See, he has like, don't show until August 31st, which I guess we can now break because it's about a week afterwards. But we all knew that August 31st meant when he uploaded his video, and he didn't upload it August 31st, so he was a bit late, but I'm going to go ahead and check out the Minute Shop next episode. That should be pretty cool. But today we are going to hold it off. And one last thing I wanted to check out was the Mob Drop Shop. So check it out, guys. I reverted to the old method. So what I did was I took it, and I'll show you what I did. I think it's more efficient this way. The model we used at our house, where there was just this little box above water, I just did it again and put four of them all in a row, and it doesn't look like any of the golems have died yet, which is awesome. And what they do is, and what I've noticed is that when it was a one line stream, one wide stream, the mobs would come up and stop right before it. So what I thought was that they didn't see them anymore. So I extended it to two, and Kermit did this fancy water trick where he made it so it still went down because it was messing up. Then they came up to here and they didn't go down. So I went to go look at the model, and it turns out we actually need to raise this one block for the mobs to feel comfortable dropping, and that might take a bit of work. So once we raise that and Dolphin decorates it a bit, makes it look fancy, the Mob Drop Shop will be complete. But today, guys, we have a casino to buy. So we're going to forward you to that, and I'll see you at the end of the episode.
Hello?
Hello?
Hey.
Hey.
What's up?
Are we recording?
Yeah.
So, hey, Razor! Hey, Dolphin! Good to see you guys!
Hey, what's
We're
up, man?
We're back on the cube!
We are back on the cube. Okay, so let's be serious here for a second. We are in front of the casino, Mr. President. We run the top floor, and it's called Tombola. Now, we had the idea that we wanted to buy out this whole casino. So today, we were going to get Tomahawk on and Dolphin, which is the real estate agent, to buy it. Unfortunately, what happened, Dolphin? You said that he chose you as his representative or something?
Yes, he did choose me as his representative to sell the casino for him.
Okay.
Can we make this feel clear? Can we make this clear? It is actually the law. He didn't choose you. It is the law for him to go to you.
I love how you always I love how you always crouch like this, Russian.
It
you're always crouching
it
around.
Is the law. I don't know why. Don't
so
know.
Yeah, in other words, Tomahawk couldn't make it, so Dolphin is selling the casino on his behalf today.
And I gotta trust in you. You're the real estate agency for the Cube SMP server.
Okay.
And as president, I approve.
All right. So Dolphin, throw us some numbers here. Now keep in mind, we want to buy this thing, but then have you make it look good. So you're gonna be doing two jobs. So you
but
might
that's
as
separate.
Yeah, you might no. He might as well just throw the price onto it because we're gonna be paying him it anyways. So just have it all in one. We'll pay him and then we'll buy it and then he'll make it look and renovate it.
Actually, yeah, that works for me because I get 10%. So if the price goes up, and then I get the 10%. And no, but then he gets it. So let's pay it as two different jobs.
Okay, two different jobs.
Keep her separate, Grace.
This is a realty agency thing, and then there's going to be a building thing.
Okay,
so,
I got you. Two separate transactions there, bud. Okay.
Exactly.
So let's go scan the interior of this build, and we'll see how
wait,
it
Grazer,
works.
We're renting the top right now, right?
Right now we are renting the top, and for us it expires on September 11th, but if we buy
it
out.
Which is in what, 4 days?
Yeah, that's closing up pretty quick here. So we should probably buy this out before this stuff happens and we lose the floor. So let's just scan this place, look at how big it is. We're probably going to be, we're changing the building around anyway, so it doesn't really matter how big the actual build is. We should probably look more at how big the land is. We have...
Well, it's not a huge, it's a decent sized land. It's not prime territory.
No.
Pretty much the build is as far as back as you can go.
All the way back to where the trees are for the horse stable. So we have a pretty good width here and we have a pretty good length. But
it's pretty good, Rusher.
It's not prime land though.
The thing is, you can see it, you know?
But we don't know how you're gonna make it once you renovate it.
Yeah, dude. The new build.
So you can't take the build right now into consideration.
So this is me asking as a builder right now, alright? Not as your real estate agent. Are beacons allowed to be used for builds?
No, I don't think so. Because that would make too many beacons that spawn. I think only beacons are allowed in the main areas. I mean, it's the president's rules. What do you think, Mr. Prez?
No, that is not legal.
Okay.
You sold the art gallery for a total of 100 gold blocks, and that was right beside spawn.
Mm-hmm.
There is no chance we got to be playing near that. This is at least three or four places down.
The thing is,
it still is pretty close to spawn, though.
You're buying a casino business. Well, remember, which is a high-end,
we haven't even
money trap.
We haven't
even
heard the numbers yet. What are you planning on selling this to us for here?
Yeah, dude.
Well, first I was like, you know what? I'm thinking 100 gold blocks. So that
you're
buying it together, right? So either 60 grazer, 40 rusher, 50-50, whatever you guys want to do.
Okay.
But I was thinking 100 because the thing is, the art gallery was bought just as land. You know, you're buying the business, and which is a casino. You got to remember that. That is high money right over there. I have a gambling problem, and I might be here every day. So this is a place where you're going to be making a bunch of money. That land, you know what? There's nothing really there that you can make a bunch of money, but a casino. This is where the money is. So if you want to just buy the land, you know, that would... And you can just have Tomahawk keep the casino, but you guys wouldn't be making any money here. So
yeah,
I'm thinking 100 gold blocks is a fair price for both you guys.
What do you think?
Well, here's the thing, bud. Like when we purchase something, like even when Grazer purchased the art gallery, you're purchasing the business too.
Yeah.
But it doesn't matter what you're using it for.
That wouldn't make any sense to own the land where someone else's business is, unless Tomahawk would just start paying us.
He'd have to pay us.
Yeah,
he'd
have to pay us.
But,
yeah. So we would still be making money, but we want the casino.
100 blocks, that's a little much, bud.
All right, see ya.
There we go. Yeah,
I want to go 80 gold blocks.
I'm thinking 70.
You think 70?
Guys.
70 gold blocks.
I can't do 70. I'm going to be honest with you. I can't do 70.
You can definitely go lower than 90. That's for certain, bud.
80.
90.
Give us a deal here.
90 is probably my lowest, guys. I'm thinking, like, you're going to be making a bunch of money here where my friend Tomahawk was making money. So, you know what? 90 is the lowest I can go.
I'm saying 80 is our highest. 80 is our highest.
80? What do you think about 80 here, Dolphin?
How about 80 and then 10% of all... all profit.
How about no? Well, we're producing millions here at the
The only the thing I'm doing is I'm only getting 10% of the
he's selling the land for Tomahawk.
Selling this.
Yeah, so that's all he's doing. Yeah.
You can do, you're going 90, we're going 80. Let's meet in the middle, 85 if you're lucky. We do 85. That's it, dude. Meeting in the middle.
The thing is,
take it or we walk, dude. No one will be buying this casino today.
All right, this is my last offer. 85 and 10%.
Dude, that's a hunk of trash.
I would like it if possible, Rusher. I mean, 10% isn't really that much money, and that's what Tomahawk originally came in with before Dolphins started adding numbers.
Well, yes, Grazer, I would like to sell the casino to you. However, it would be on the condition that I get 10% of all future earnings from said casino.
We could do a cheap price right now up front and then give him 10% because it's not really a lot. If we get 10 gold blocks, he literally only gets one gold block out of those 10.
Yeah, dude. But if we get 100 gold blocks, he gets 10. I'm willing to do 10%, bud. But this price has to be way down.
It's got to be a bit lower.
80 blocks.
Remember, Dolphin. Remember, Dolphin. Tomahawk was coming in just with the 10%. He had no numbers on it. But you wouldn't make any money off of that. I know. So we need to add a number here.
10% will give you 5 gold blocks and hook you up with this build deal.
You guys have got to realize 10% is only for the business.
Yeah.
You realize that, right?
Oh, yeah, the land.
I'm selling you a piece of land.
Dude.
We don't do percentages and a small price for a big hunk of land here. This is a pretty big plot. Almost as big as the courthouse over here.
Here, how about this, Dolphin?
Right.
10%
and 60.
We could do that, but Grazer, 60? Are you serious? 10% of a company, dude. That's a lot of money for Tomahawk.
But it all depends
Dolphin's
how much.
Worried about his.
Okay,
it
really depends on how much the 10% is worth. Like, are we gonna be adding new games? Are we gonna just keep
dude,
the same
we're
stuff?
We're making this thing good.
Well, it also depends on how long the 10% lasts for. Is that gonna last forever, a certain amount of time? Like, what are we talking about here? We need some details.
Dude, Frank, we can take it, Grazer, mostly because we can't out-negotiate. My partner here is negotiating.
And that way, Tomahawk
team.
Gets what he wants. Dolphin gets what he wants. Everybody's happy because Tomahawk came in with 10% originally.
Exactly.
He gets his 10%.
Our competitors are happy. That's what matters, Grace.
I'm just trying to make everyone happy and have
their
own
land.
Yeah,
it's all about fairness in these negotiations.
You can discuss with my friend Tomahawk about the 10% because that's not my area.
All
right, I'm going to need those 60 gold blocks.
Dang it.
Yeah, dude, I had the cash on me up front.
You know, Grace has got to go to the ATM over there.
Yeah, dude.
Good thing there's an ATM, right?
That's the thing with me on Cube.
Dude, it's literally on the ground. Why aren't you picking it up?
Yo, you guys aren't moving.
You look lagging.
You're lagging, dude.
All right, Grazer. Well, what do you think about that deal?
Oh, there's two of them now.
Yo!
Yo, your money's right there. Your money's right there.
Two Dolphins. Thanks. Now, what about the bill, dude? What are you thinking, Grazer?
Okay, so, yeah, land has been sold. Land has been sold to us. Depending on what Dolphin actually does with the casino, how much he renovates. I want this whole current build taken down. Like, I don't like it at all. I want it to be completely renovated.
So yeah, so I'm thinking. I'll give you guys, give me a general idea about what you kind of want, what kind of style you want, and then I'll hit you up after for the price.
So here's what Grazer and I are thinking.
Yeah.
Yeah, you tear down the whole freaking thing, and then you rebuild it.
Yeah, that's what we're thinking right now. And I want you to rebuild it, like, looking like an actual casino. Have, like, lights everywhere that attract the customers, flashing stuff. Yeah, kind of like Las Vegas.
I tried, dude, but there's no beacons are allowed. But,
Yeah, dude, two levels we'll need. One for tombola, one for something else.
All right.
And we plan to implement more games too, so make sure you make room for more. Yep, I actually have an idea for a third game that I got in the comments. So thank you, Dolphin. We'll come back when the build is done. Bye bye. Aha, the casino has been completed and it's got my banner on it. So Rusher needs to put his on the other side, but if we enter in, the first thing I noticed was that it's a bit smaller than the older one. There's the top floor and the lower floor. It looks a lot better. But I do not think we would be able to fit Tombola up here on the top floor. It's just too small. So I told Dolphin that, and we've already started to extend down here via stairs, and we're gonna have like a big open room. Then we ran into this hole. I think this is just a natural cave system, so it shouldn't be too big of a deal. The only thing we're worried about is this. It kind of runs into Stacy's stables a bit, so I don't want any of her horses getting down into the casino way, so I might have to put some dirt there. There, I kind of blocked it off, but as you can see, well, I guess it doesn't really run into it anymore. But now, guys, as you can see, I have a Tombola pickaxe in my inventory. We have a Tombola pickaxe missing. I think it's time we get to the bottom of this. Tomahawk, how are you doing, buddy?
Hey, hi, Grace. How's it going?
Tomahawk, don't you be looking innocent today. I see what's in your hand. We've gotten to the bottom of it. We didn't even need to get the police on it. We're in front of the police station right here, Tomahawk. You spoiled it in your latest episode. You have been in possession of the Tombola pickaxe this entire time.
Oh, I have?
You have.
Oh, I had no idea. I don't know anything about this sort of thing.
So,
I just showed up in my inventory one day.
It just showed up? When was the last time you played Tombola the game?
Oh, like 3 weeks ago, buddy.
So that's 21 days you've had this pickaxe on you without having it returned. Do you think right now, Tomahawk, I want to be completely honest with you. Here, drop me the pickaxe real quick. So Tomahawk, let me just ask you a question. Because you possess this pickaxe on you for 3 weeks without having said a word, do you think that you should be consequenced for this action?
This pigman says I don't.
But what do you think in your head?
I agree with the pigman.
You don't think you should be consequenced at all?
I don't think so. I think it was an honest mistake. I had no idea that I had it. I just forgot to put it back. And since I wasn't playing, I had no idea that I had it. And then when I did realize I had it, it was because it was the first time I had played and recorded since I had played Tombola.
Okay, I'm going to let you off on this one here, Tomahawk. But if this happens again, you're going to be fined, buddy. You're going to be fined a good amount of money. Here it is, the newly renovated casino.
I don't know what it looks like. I mean the face, like it, right here, you see like the opening right there?
Yeah.
It kind of looks like a scary face in a way.
It does? Oh yeah, I can see that. It looks like a I actually see that. That's funny. Yeah. But if we enter in here, we haven't done anything with the rooms yet. We plan to make a downstairs down there for some more games, and then there's going to be an upper part here. Basically the same format as what the casino used to be. But, thank you so much, Mr. Tomahawk, for returning the Tombola pickaxe. Now, if you want to collect the fees that you get from Dolphin, he gets 10%. You get the rest of the 60 gold blocks.
All right, I'll be sure to go talk to him.
Okay.
Thank you, though.
All right, and yeah, this casino is now Russianized. So yeah,
have fun with the casino, Grazer.
Thank
and,
you, buddy.
I'm glad I no longer have to go look for diamonds every once in a while because that was always a pain. Have fun with your thing, enjoy yourself, and have fun with your cliche trying to kill me at the end of the clip type things.
All right, bye, Patrick Clone, buddy.
Grazer MC.
Ridiculous. Oh, that's gonna. So we are at the mushroom shop today.
Not even gonna acknowledge that.
We are at the mushroom shop today. Did I tell you about the lawsuit, by the way? Yeah, so Stacy and I resolved everything. There's not gonna be a lawsuit. She just basically put it back in, and I think she bought a mushroom off of us as well. And that's what I need to talk to you about today, is the split in profit. So we've actually had a lot of purchases since our last confrontation. By multiple people, and we've been making quite a bit of profits off of this shop. It's been working out for us here, Pat. Really? No one's bought the mushroom stew, though. Most people have been buying the mooshrooms. And that's what I wanted to talk to you about today. So go ahead and... Oh, and I wanted to show you down here. So Stacy redecorated. Wow. And now there's a fake sky, and there's like mushroom walls and mycelium on the ground. But here's
nice.
Here's the payments chest.
Very
nice. That's how much we've made so far. Now, here's the deal. Right. If I go ahead and split this up, this is what I wanted to talk to you about. So... the delivery fee. Tomahawk and Straub wanted their mushrooms delivered to their house by me, and I charged a fee of 2 gold blocks and 5 gold ingots per delivery fee. I'm wondering if we can exclude that from the total price where we split the profits, because I think that I should get that since I did that all.
Yeah, it's yours. You delivered it.
Okay, so I get all that, and then this was here because Straub, I think this should go to both of us because this affects the company in itself. Now, that's the shearing fee. Now, Straub was being a prankster, and he said, here, take some shears, Grazer, and go ahead and shear one of the mushroom cows, and I didn't know it turned it back into a regular cow, so he had to go ahead and pay the fee for that as well. So I'll add that to the company profits, and in total, then, the company has made 28 gold blocks, which, if we go ahead and split into 4, is 7. I get 7, and you get the rest, which is 75%. And I get 11 gold blocks, or however many that was.
That's good, buddy. That's good. I like this. I like this decoration. This is actually pretty nice.
And
we're probably gonna have to breed these guys too here pretty soon.
Actually, I have some wheat. Let me go.
Yeah, I do too. There you go.
I actually already delivered the mushroom cows, so I had to bring more in here to get repopulation going. I think if our shop continues to be as successful as it is, and I know H-Bomb actually suggested the idea for mushroom cows, so we're going to get at least one purchase more in the future. We need to keep repopulating down here.
Yeah, so that'd be a good idea.
Okay, well, that's all I wanted to really resolve with you today was getting that on top of things. Make sure I get all the money from the delivery fees.
All right, see you later, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Oh, what the? What are you doing, buddy? No.
Dang it. Aha, so now we have both tombola pickaxes. The case has been solved. We have a new casino here. Now all we need to do is install the games. Now you might be wondering, where are all the prizes? Well, the prizes are all in my ender chest. I have all of them, the nether star, everything we use as prizes. I'm going to start loading them back up into the casino so that we can call it open. I just don't know whether we're going to do it on the top floor or down in the bottom yet. And if we're doing it in the bottom, we need a room down there. So it should be pretty cool. I think there's room that we can extend and expand into more games as well, which is awesome. Aha, so I read a lot of your comment suggestions last episode on what I should probably put here in this plot that I purchased, and I haven't actually chosen a comment yet. I don't know what I'm gonna put here, so it's still up in the air. I have some ideas, I just haven't finalized it. I need to make do with the short length that I have, but also the big width that I can use. Actually, it would be the other way around, right? Width and then length to the back. Depends on how you look at it, I guess. So that is going to wrap it up for today's episode of the Cube SMP server. I hope you guys all enjoyed. And here's our new casino. Haha. And I will see you guys all again next time. Bye bye. So we were originally going to extend the floor down this way. And we went down here and we found a problem. The kitchen is there. So I was like, no biggie. We can have it extend that way. So we start extending it that way. We start going down, why not? The reed farm is here. There's so much stuff underground now. It's almost unbelievable.